After, oh, she's what? It's been like 4 days of not playing. Finally back. And fracture Ashla lightsaber, huh? Oh, that is expensive. I wonder what it looks like, though. That is kind of neat looking, but it's still expensive. Oh, it's even got a little thing at the bottom. That's kind of cool. Zyost Guardian lightsaber. Ooh. Actually, I think I have some lightsabers that are kind of shaped like that. Oh, it's got the tuning on it. All right. Well, kind of. So yeah, of course, just things have happened over the week. I mean, nothing bad, just life got in the way of playing, which is what happens when you're a casual gamer. You don't get a whole lot of time to do a whole lot of stuff. But I'm back for now. Don't know how much I'm gonna be able to play this. It's Friday right now. Is that supposed to be up there? Huh. Okay, well, let me get on my thing. Lots of ums. Apparently, the server that I'm on, this Satil Shan, it was migrated to a cloud server on Wednesday. Today's Friday. That was Wednesday the 20th. September 20th, 2023. I usually put a date on my videos anyway, but if you're just watching this and not wanting to really found any client, huh? Not really look it up. That's what it was. So I'll see how well that actually does, or if it makes any kind of difference to my gameplay. Yeah, yesterday I went out, my cousin was in town, and I tried burning down my house.
I've got good suppliers. Only the best sold here.
Not because my cousin was town, but because,
Feel free to browse.
yeah, my cousin was in town. Came in from, she lives over in Florida, so way on the other side of the United States, inside of a state that I don't want to go to, but she came and visited, and so yeah, she's like, oh, you want to go out, have coffee or dinner or something? Like, oh, well, I gotta work, so coffee's out of the thing. It's like, well, how about we just have dinner? So, of course, set up to have dinner, and we're waiting. And the previous night, I had to order pizza because I was like, oh, I know Thursday's gonna be, this is Thursday's gonna be busy because it's today I have all my phone calls and stuff. And am I going the wrong way or am I not? I need the other way. So I was like, I'm going to be busy. Wednesday, I'm tired. I'll just have pizza. I order pizza. We'll have leftovers. We can have pizza on Wednesday and Thursday. Okay, why? Oh, that's Republic. Oh, I went the wrong way. I thought things looked weird. I was like, oh, this looks kind of familiar. But she went ahead and, yeah, she wanted to go out. So the reason I'm telling you I got pizza is because the pizza, we get this place called Pagliacci's, and they got some big pizzas. So I left the boxes. Wednesday night, whatever we didn't eat, I put inside of a Tupperware container, put in the fridge, and left the pizza boxes on the stove, thinking, okay, well, I'll probably take them out Thursday, either before I start work or after I get off work. One of the two. Well, one thing led to another. I left the pizza boxes on the stove. Usually not an issue. Somehow, and nobody knows how, whether it was my wife or I did it by accident, the kid did it by accident, or one of the cats jumped up on the counter because they've done that too and they've did it. Somehow the stove got turned on, just barely. So I come walking, it's about an hour and a half before I go to meet my cousin for dinner. I come walking in the kitchen and there's smoke. And there's smoke and there's fire. Not a lot of fire, but a lot of smoke. So yeah, first thing I did is I grabbed the pizza boxes, pulled them off the oven, shut the oven off, or moved them off of the burner it was
Vehicle
on.
pads are currently open for business.
Shut the stove off, not the oven. Shut the stove off. I was going to throw them in the sink, but the problem is the pizza box is too big. There's sink, and the sink had dishes in it from dishes I was going to go ahead and put in the dishwasher at the end of my workday, but I hadn't yet. So yeah, pizza boxes should have been thrown away. Dishes should have been taken care of. So what it is, open the window. Fortunately, our back patio is not that far away from the kitchen. So took the pizza box that was on fire. So got like a little bit of burning embers on it. And the fire's out. And threw down the patio, grabbed the hose, and sprayed it down really good. But yeah, there was a lot of smoke at the kitchen. So I'm opening windows, I'm grabbing fans. And again, fortunately, I got fans all over the place because we just got done with summer. It's now kind of fall. Well, it's officially fall tomorrow, but it's getting a lot colder, so we don't have fans in the windows much. And I hadn't put them away for the winter. So I'm throwing fans in the windows, trying to get the smoke out before it sets off the smoke alarms, and, or worse, gets the fire department out here again. And, you know, have to text back my cousin and go, oh, by the way, we're going to be late because somebody in this household tried to burn the house down. But fortunately, that did not happen. But my house, our house does still smell like smoke. It's been days, you know. I open the windows and I've been trying to clear the place out. It's like stuck. I cleaned up. I made sure there was, you know, it wasn't like a lot of fire. It was just mostly smoke. The only thing that burned was the pizza box, and it wasn't like the full pizza. It just like burned a hole in it. So it wasn't like extremely bad. The worst part of everything is the smoke. And we live in a two-bedroom townhouse, so it's not upstairs. It's all downstairs, which is good. We got air purifiers. I've had air purifiers for years because we're used to the smoke during the summer. And, you know, and also because the apartment we lived in before had mold. And there's my dead drop. Let's see if I get a cutscene from that.
You're holding a verse outfit, part of the pilgrim's ritual to the Shining Man's tomb. Best way to avoid drawing unwanted attention. Tradition says the pilgrim's supposed to collect ceremonial offerings from the seeker's path. That'll be your first stop. Then the tomb itself. Just watch out for the subhumans. The Voss call them Gormak. But all you need to know is that they're vermin with blasters.
Okay. Don't know why my character looks so disinterested when everybody's hearing that. But anyway. Yeah, so the place that we moved from formerly, it had mold bad in the house. It worse was in my kid's room. And we, you know, they had them replace the carpet and, well, we had them replace the padding. We finally got them to do that. But they, you know, fought us tooth and nail on that. We had a mold, short of actually having somebody come out there and do the mold, you know, the professional come out to it, we did one, you can get a mold test. From like a Home Depot or Lowe's or whatever. And I got one from Depot, got a couple of them from Depot, ran a couple different times. And yeah, definitely mold. You could smell it. There was no, I mean, it's like you shouldn't even need a test. That's how obvious it was. But yeah, they fought us tooth and nail. And the thing is, whenever we moved in there, they showed us another apartment. And I'm like, oh, well, the apartment you're going to move in is over here, but it's not quite ready yet. And, you know, here's one just like it. I'm like, okay, well, you know, that's not bad. And the problem with that was they didn't show us the one that we ended up moving into. Come to find out, the reason why they didn't show us because it did have mold. They knew about it. They didn't care. I mean, obviously, it was on us to prove it, and then we'd have to pay somebody to come out and prove it, and then they'd be like, so... But yeah, I'd bought an air purifier, which also helped for both the smoke and for the mold. And I mean, it had both. It could help purify both just for my kid, because like, it's bad enough they got to sleep in this room, you know. And we wanted to move, and things, of course, you know. Whenever you have kids, and you're working all the time, and your wife is, you know, my wife was constantly sick still. And it's like, it was difficult to move in the first place, getting the money to, getting the time to. I actually had to move all of us from that apartment to where we currently live. I had to be the one to do it by myself because I couldn't find anybody else, couldn't afford anybody else. You know, I wanted to have, I was going to ask my brother to help, but he had to work. And I was like, well, not waiting
Be all right.
because I went out of this apartment as soon as possible. And that about killed me doing that. But anyway, yeah, so we got air purifiers because of that old apartment, and I keep them up in our bedrooms, and when the windows are closed, you know, turn them on. Whenever it smokes bad, turn them on. And even made one of those do-yourself air purifiers where you get if you have a, oh, I thought I could go that way, I guess not. You have a box fan you can buy. It's like a 20 by 20, 20 inch by 20 inch filter, and just tape it to the box fan or bungee cords or whatever. But so yeah, I got those running, got windows and doors open downstairs, got fans going. I had them going this morning, but it was 50 degrees outside. And man, does it get cold in the house. I'm trying to do my work and I'm just like sitting. I was like, it's 60 in here. I'm cold. Yeah. My coffee went cold real quick. That wasn't good, but yeah, it'll, you know, it's gonna take a few days for all the smoke get out of here. Unfortunately, it was a lot of smoke. When I was trying to open up the window, just my eyes were burning, but like, you know, kind of knew that I had to do it, otherwise it was gonna set stuff off. Had to get the smoke out as quickly as possible, and you know, gotta just push through the pain. And but yeah, got most of the smoke out and as much as could possible, got things secured, went met my cousin for dinner, told her the story, and she's like, yeah, it's like, yeah, I know. I was telling my wife to go, this is, my wife's all, she goes, oh, I'm so sorry it's happened. Like, well, you know, it's not your fault unless you did it. I don't know if you did it. I don't know if I did by accident, if I accidentally hit it when I was getting ice cream for the kid or something. I don't know. Just, I don't think so. I've never done that, but you know, says, you know, no need to apologize. Says, my life is just like that. Somehow things happen. And you know, you plan on it for it to be boring. You don't want things to happen, but things just happen. I said, you know, kind of just roll with it. Be thankful that it didn't burn down the house, that the only real burn damage was the pizza box and one of the knobs for the stove got a little singed because whenever I moved the pizza box, I moved the pizza boxes. The bottom one, the one that actually did catch fire, that burnt a hole in it, that went ahead and touched the knob and it melted a little. It's like, my wife's like, well, we're not getting our deposit back. And it's like, I can just go to Lowe's or Depot and pick up a new knob. I'm sure they probably sell them somewhere. I said, if, you know, worst comes to worst, you know, we won't get our deposit back, but it's not like badly burned. Like, it's still usable. And it's not like extremely disformed. I was like, but yeah, I could probably find a new knob if I need to. It's not gonna be a big deal. Just like with the blinds. Yeah. One of my cats chewed on the blinds. But I know you can get replacement ones. Because I've had to do it before. Not for this place, but other places, so. For actually my old condo, whenever I moved inside there, I had to get a couple replacements. Because the people I bought it from, they I think they had dogs. And the dogs had destroyed like one of the blinds. So it's like, yeah, so there, I mean, it's not cheap and it's not easy, but it's better than have to pay for brand new ones or have to lose your deposit or something, you know. So yeah, that was yesterday. I spent all morning on phone calls. I didn't get to take a lunch, and finally, I'm like, "Oh, finally, the day's over. I'm gonna relax and go out for dinner with my cousin. I haven't seen her in a couple years because you know, besides the pandemic, just haven't really had time or money to do anything. Yeah, she didn't grow up with us as much, and us, me and my brother, says we, her dad was kind of around, but he kind of kept her away from everybody else because we're a messed up family, and he knows we're a messed up family. He's from my mom's side, and he's like, yeah, I don't want my kids to grow up like, you know, I did or my siblings did. And smart guy about that.
You took a nasty fall.
I didn't take a nasty fall. I got bit. There's a huge difference. So, but yeah, we kind of, I mean, we've kept in touch over the years, and she lived here when I moved up here. In fact, yeah, so when the time, it was when my uncle got pulled over for, next to my apartment.
Now.
She had come up like right about the same time or right after, I didn't want to say. So he was like, yeah, why don't you go pick Thomas up? Because I'm less likely to pick up a young female in the area than they are an older man driving a Cadillac. What are these tables for? Oh, it's the shiny man is. Ooh. Yeah, right now my wife and my kid, they're out for the school's doing like a little fundraiser bingo. My kid loves playing bingo at school, so they make it fun. I know usually bingo's for older people, but you know, it's kind of starting to see like resurgence of younger people doing some fun stuff that older people like. And it's good, it gets my wife out of the house. She's kind of been feeling a little bit down, you know. A little bit worried that the problems she was having, it's been ending her in the hospital, they're coming back. But she's not been having, you know, she has some weird pains, like, well, but they're not the familiar pains, they're different. So, I'm like, it could, she goes, well, I'm hoping it's not all in my head. And I'm like, I don't know. It might be, you might have some pain, but then again, could you have some pain? And then it might be psychosomatic. I said, I don't know. I was, but I do know whenever you're out and doing stuff, you don't seem to get in this pain. I go, so it might be a lot of it's, might be your just fears and stuff manifesting themselves physically. So, okay, let's open up sarcophagus. Take a break from my yapping.
This is fantastic. This must be what Korriban is like.
Nope.
Cypher, I don't even care that it's a monument to our enemy. It's too perfect.
Empty?
Bastan, I'm in position. Nothing in the sarcophagus but dust and a scroll.
Dust? No way the body decayed that fast on its own. Send me a high-res image and bring the scroll back. Dust sample, too. We'll see what analysis turns up.
I'll head back to the tea house.
I'll save a seat for you.
Well, I'd hope you'd save a seat for me. No, you're on your own. Alright, do you want to quick travel back there? Let's quick travel back there. It'd be a lot easier. They didn't give me a pass. That's okay. Oh, I can't quick travel to the cantina. Huh. That's weird. Yeah, we'll just hit the Imperial area. Yeah, I wish, I don't think they had quick travel with us. I'm trying to remember if they had Star Wars Galaxies or not. No, we didn't, because you would have to do is you'd have to wait for the shuttle. You'd have to find, there are some aspects I did like about Star Wars Galaxies, so. And I'd like to see him kind of, not really inserted, but kind of, I'd like to see some of those things kind of in this game, or at least a new game. But the one thing I did not like was the shuttles. And you would pretty much have to, if you didn't have a vehicle and had to walk everywhere, it was horrendous because I had huge worlds. And it was just open, of course. Because it was, like I said, what's called a sandbox game. So basically you do whatever you wanted to, wherever you wanted to, kind of. And yeah, the only way to get shuttles, there were shuttles in the major cities, the major NPC cities. But those were mostly few and far between. And to get other, so you'd have to drive, you'd have to have a mount, some kind of speeder usually, or... Hold on.
You return, Father, your friend.
Come share our meal. My brother Theridon is with us. We celebrate.
You could tell me of your time on Voss.
Yeah, I'm raiding... I'm killing things and I'm raiding tombs.
Thank you. Dinner sounds lovely.
Come, meet Theridon and my son.
Vamoye allows me to work in the alien enclave. Outsider faces, outsider materials.
You will never be an artist. But it is right. Your people bring vast opportunities. Be proud of your role.
We have a lot to offer this planet and a lot to learn from you.
Many outsiders save us. The three are patient. They will see.
Father's friends introduced outsider goods. Is that how you met?
I'm sure Bastan could tell the story better.
Our story is not important. We have spoken enough. Our guest grows tired.
Your company is welcome.
I appreciate you putting up with that. Let's get to work. I'll send the ashes for analysis, but I'm more interested in the scroll. It's sort of an epitaph, calls the Shining Man a man of prophecy, who was made whole in the wellspring of the Shrine of Healing.
Man of prophecy? Something to do with the Voss Force Sensitive?
The mystics have a whole library of prophecies. The rest of the Voss revere the mystics because their prophecies are always right. If the mystics prophesied the Shining Man's arrival, it would explain why the Voss accepted him so easily. It's awfully convenient, though.
Convenient is one word for it. Any chance a prophecy was manipulated?
Always that chance. About the second part of the scroll, though. Made whole in the wellspring of the Shrine. The Shrine of Healing is a mystic sanctuary where people go to be cured. The sick and dying, or the spiritually wounded. Only a handful of pilgrims manage to complete the trek each year. I'd guess if the Shining Man was there, it wasn't for spiritual reasons.
I need to find out what the Shining Man was up to.
There's a pilgrimage camp not too far from Voss Kaa. One of the guides there can help you reach the shrine and the wellspring. My advice, if you'll take it, play by the mystic's rules. It's not wise to defy the order of things.
Well, as a professional spy, that would actually be sound advice too. Given I don't want to rock the boat too much, and I don't want to bring too much tension to myself, and if I start breaking the rules, I will do both of those things, won't I? So anyway, so going back to Star Wars Galaxies. So what you do is, so for shuttles, besides the ones in major cities, you could go ahead and, as a player, you could build them. Now, the thing was, though, you had to be part of a city, a player-made city. There was lots of players who usually get together and make cities, so I'd say there's a lot of them, but depend on which version you made, depend on how many players there were, too. And they could have stuff like shuttles and, oops, I'm going the wrong way again. I keep wanting to go to the Republic side because that's the side I'm used to playing. the player city. So, you know, if you got enough players in the city, you got enough houses, you could start, you know, and you got yourself a mayor. The mayor could go ahead and allow you to build shuttles, allow you to build cantinas and medical facilities and stuff like that. In fact, there was, yeah, so if you were lucky enough to happen on a player city that had a shuttle, that was great. But most of the time you were on, yeah, you'd have to take your whatever transport you had, or had to walk if it, your transport blew up or you're too poor to afford anything. Which, again, I mean, it's a sandbox game, so it wasn't like you had somewhere to be most of the time.
Welcome. Please select an available travel route.
You didn't have, like, a quest that you were trying to go on, like, now, like I'm doing. Like, oh, you got to go point A, point B. It's like, nope, you just, you're going to do some things. Maybe you're doing what's called hunting for badges. And that was to go to, like, certain spots or do certain things that earn you a badge in the game. Like, visiting Obi-Wan's abandoned home on Tatooine. Or seeing the Krayt Dragon graveyard, Tatooine, or visiting the Great Falls on Naboo and stuff like that. But yeah, it was just mostly, so you spent a lot of time just running, just traveling. And then you got where you wanted to go and you hoped that you didn't die there. Because you didn't have a companion, it was just you, no companion. In fact, this game was kind of, and it came out, the whole fact that they're like, yeah, you're going to have a companion who can heal you or fight with you. That was a new concept, that you didn't have a companion. Now, along with some of the, I mean, this game's actually brought a lot of new stuff that most MMOs at the time that this game came out did not have. The cutscenes, the voice actors, some of them have cinematics, but yeah, the cutscenes, the voice actors really didn't get a whole lot of that. The unique stories for each class, because again, most MMOs are like, oh, here's your class, choose your side, you all kind of get the same story, just a little bit of sprinkle flavor here and there. So waxing nostalgia. But like I said, if you can find a copy of Star Wars Galaxies somewhere, you can probably go ahead and play on one of the servers, the fan-made servers. And I hope someday, you know, eventually this game's going to be old and they're going to, say the word kill it. Yeah, they're going to kill it. I mean, of course, if you believe the online talk, and it's always, ever since the game came out, oh, the game's dying, it's dead, they're going to shut down servers. And like, yeah, that's another one. I will believe it when I see it. Or I will believe it when the people running the game actually say it. Until then, I'm not going to hold my breath. And I'm going to miss the game. You know, if one does eventually go away, I'll probably miss it, even though I do not play every day right now. I'm a very casual player because it is, you know, for me, it's just a fun release to be able to play this game and, you know, geek out a little bit about Star Wars. You know, be able to play with the lightsaber and not have to be, well, I like this, then again, I like playing the Force Unleashed, other Star Wars games too, but I like this one because it's more, I like the open world, I like the role-playing part of it. But another one will always come up. The game engine will get better. Graphics will, you know, the graphics have gotten better on this game. That's a good thing. They're not as stagnant as they used to be. I mean, all right, let's check out the lower objects.
Stand by for examination and suggested products.
But I'm looking for, I'm looking
for duty. Return to your post.
I just wish I could play this game on more than just this, my desktop computer. Because it's a pain to try to play sometimes. Well, not like that, but I do a lot of stuff. And like I think I've said mentioned before, this is not in the same room as my work computer. Because I want to keep them separate, because I don't want the distraction there, even though I know myself.
I saw ruins on Droman Cast when I was a child, but I've never seen an alien shrine. I'm quite excited.
Yeah, I know myself. I won't be distracted. I'll try to keep myself from being distracted, but I don't want to put anything... I don't want to have the computer close enough for me to have that urge to be distracted. You know, it's hard enough sometimes. I'm working, 9.5, 10-hour days sometimes, just trying to get stuff caught up. And I really don't want to drop the ball, especially because I'm supposed to be the one taking over for my boss, and I don't have a backup. I'm her backup right now. And she's kind of still my backup, but I don't want to... I have a very strong work ethic, and I don't want to mess with it. And that's what I should say, and keeping distractions on my way is a great way to make sure that I keep that work ethic. I'm going to have to talk this person on. Get close, watch. I'm going to get a cutscene. Yep.
You have faced the trials, outsider, but the wellspring is for the broken.
Another outsider came here once. I have questions about him.
The mystics tend the wellspring. The mystics make bodies and minds whole. I disturb them for nothing less.
Should I lie? Should I go light side or should I threaten him? I'll go light side.
I may be an outsider, but I need guidance. There are terrible things in my past. I sometimes wonder who I am.
I will take you to Amin Lay.
Technically that's true.
You must do this alone.
If the Shining Man was here, he might have gone through the same thing. See where it goes?
That's the plan.
The fracture is deep. To rebuild a body, a spirit, one rebuilds history. The Vitalicron is the vessel of memory. Each petitioner fills. In a Vitalicron, the ceremony is preserved.
These Vitalicrons remember everyone who comes here?
Yes. Breathe the mists and speak true. You are the tree. Your roots, the past, the universe is soil. The tree is sick. See what nurtures the roots, and remember a homeworld of ice. A proud people, never trusting. Who were you then?
I knew the Empire disdained non-humans. I thought I would be the exception.
Perhaps you were, at times. Consider now the seasons that shape the tree. First, a season of fire. You purged a darkness by kindling the blaze. Many screamed, but you did what no other could. Then a season of famine. You stood alone. Your friends and foes carved the wood of your mind. Speak of the wound. Speak of your strength.
No matter how many lies I live, I do fight for a reason. My strength is there.
Only if you truly understand. Now you are in a season of mists. All things are obscured. Your spirit burns angry, like frost. But this cannot endure forever. You must change. What will you become?
No more control. No more orders. I want to choose my own fate.
Then you are truly healed.
The Honored One, Amin Lay, has spoken. The healing has been recorded. You hold a Vitalicron, the memory of your wholeness, technologically stored. It must go to our vaults.
I can't let this fall into the wrong hands.
Each Vitalicron is genetically locked. Only its creator may know what happened. 10,000 and more are stored in the vault. Honor us by placing yours within.
Want to see what the Shining Man left for us?
Of course. Why wouldn't I? But which one? Oh, maybe the shiny one.
Bastan, I found a record of the Shining Man's visit to the shrine, but it's genetically locked.
Good thing you went tomb robbing. Sending the genetic workup on the Shining Man's ashes now. My contacts didn't find any identity matches, by the way. No evidence he existed before Voss.
Whatever this conspiracy is, its people aren't careless. Keep looking. Attempting to unlock the Vitalicron now. Looping you in on the audio feed.
Interface activated. Warning, the memory is corrupted. Came to us from the Nightmare Lands. You knew our ways. You bore a scroll.
I remember so little. What did the scroll say?
A prophecy from the Chamber of Ashes. It had been lost to us.
Die! Go back to the Nightmare Lands. Grateful for your trust, but I must leave soon for Voskar.
Trust does not matter. The prophecy you found speaks of you. You are healed. You are the Shining Man.
Huh. Doesn't tell us why the Shining Man was sent here, but now we know how he conned the Voss.
He manufactured a prophecy somehow and came to the shrine to earn the mystic's approval. Then on to Voskar.
Where the regular Voss learned to love him. What worries me is where he claims to have gotten that prophetic scroll. The Nightmare Lands are forbidden to the Voss. Legend says the ruins drive people insane, and our scouts come back in parts. Old ruins might be the only place he could find materials to fake a scroll of prophecy. But there's nowhere worse on the planet.
I want to know exactly where he's been.
Then I'll dig up what I can. But we've got some prep work to do. Meet me back at the tea house. Bastan out.
All right, we're heading back to tea house. Sorry, just talking and I think a little bit of smoke in the air is kind of getting me, my voice weird. I'll just take quick travel again. It's always back to tea house over and over and over again. Yeah, I can kind of, I don't know if it's like I'm smelling the smoke or if it's just all in my head. Or it's a little bit of A and a little bit of B, but I'm going to have to open up these windows pretty soon here. Or some more of these windows. Ooh, you know what? I haven't watched this week's episode of Ahsoka, and I hear it's really good. I'm trying to avoid all the spoilers and stuff people talk about online. But it came out on Wednesday, and you know, Thursday tried burning down my house, and went out for dinner, and today's Friday, so yeah. Well, since my wife and kid are out for like the next hour, I should do that. Yeah, let me go back to tea house and I think I'll log out for the day. I know it's probably gonna be a short video. I didn't start my timer. Usually I start my timer. But I forgot because I'm tired. It's been a long week. Next week's gonna be fun. I gotta start work at like 2:30 in the morning on Monday. Because I got to talk to India. So that's going to be a great way to start out the week. It's going to be kind of busy. Got my year-end review. I got a couple more meetings. You know, such fun. Always fun. Let's go see it.
You believe in the commandos?
I believe in my father's judgment. Outsider, there's something you must see.
Something's wrong. Tell me.
This came to us. It speaks to you.
Hello, Agent. Hope you get this in time, because your friend Baston doesn't have long. He's safe for now, but you know the drill. This stays between us. You want him back? Come to these coordinates. It's out in the Gormak lands, but that shouldn't be a problem for you.
We do not know him. The message came when Baston went into the city.
I've put your father in danger. I'll do everything I can to bring him back.
My father trusted you, outsider. I trust you. Call on us. We come to your side.
My first hostage crisis. I'll follow your lead.
Why am I turning back and talking to... My character turned to walk away, then turned right back.
You'll be all right.
Turned around and walked right back to him. That was kind of weird. But in any case, like I said, I'm going to go ahead and head back to Cantina now, and I'm going to log out. Because I got other stuff I want to do, including open up the windows. I'm just happy, like I said, I'm happy the smoke's not gone into our bedrooms. Despite having air purifiers in there. But I still want out here because I do not like the smell of it. Let's sell off some stuff first. Oh, just pants. Alright, well, hopefully I will talk at all of you again. Maybe I'll do a couple. You know what I should do on the weekends is I should record like a couple different sessions. I'll think about it. Alright, well, thank you for watching. If you're watching, and hopefully I will do these more regularly again. I'm going to get through these because I really am wanting to go do a Sith warrior or... actually, I'd like to do the Sith... The Sith Inquisitor is kind of fun, too. I want to do one of those. I like my agent, but I really love close combat. I like lightsaber combat. So maybe a Sith warrior. But anyway, okay, well, thank you for watching, and hopefully I will be back soon. Till next time, bye.